Today, I want to show you guys the substitution method for solving equations. And let's take a look at this one for example. We are solving x squared plus 6x plus 1 times x squared plus 6x minus 3, and that's equal to 5. So the first thing that you don't want to do is to multiply this and that out, because you'll get so many terms, it's going to be too long. So what do we do though? Well, notice that x squared plus 6 is in common, and that's the key. That's where the substitution comes in. You can start off by saying, pick a different letter besides x. Y, Z, T, A, B, C, whatever. But I'm going to pick U, because this would be just like the calculus integral U substitution. Anyways, pick U equal x squared plus 6x. So now we can take this equation to the U world. This is the u, so we can write u plus 1 times, this is the u, minus 3, and that is equal to, that is 5. Now, this is a much better equation, and in fact, it's going to be a quadratic equation in terms of u. Here though, do not make this equal 5, do not make this equal 5 and solve, because this is a 5. You can only do that when the right-hand side is equal to 0. When two numbers multiply to be 5, you don't know what the first number is. Okay, so multiply this out. This times this, we get u squared. This times that is negative 3u. This times that is plus u. So together, we have minus 2u. 1 times negative 3 is negative 3, and that is equal to 5. So subtract 5 to both sides, and we can get u squared minus 2u minus 8 is equal to 0. Can we factor this? Yes, because we only have u squared, we just need u and u. Now, two numbers multiply to negative 8, and together they add up to negative 4. Negative 2, we need negative 4m plus 2. Now, this times this is equal to 0, then you can do the usual thing. Put this equal 0 and put that equal 0. So u is equal to 4 or u is equal to negative 2. But we are not done yet, because the goal is to find out what x is, not just the u. So here we have two cases. The first case is when u is equal to 4. This is going to be what? U is x squared plus 6x. So we will have that. And now it's equal to 4. And now this is a quadratic equation, and normally we will just subtract 4 to both sides and try to factor this, but I'll tell you it's not factorable. So either the quadratic formula or completing a square. Which one do we do? Not a formula, completing a square, because we have a 1 in front of the x squared already. And the coefficient of x is even, so completing a square is much faster. Look at the coefficient of this, which is 6, multiply with 1 half. Square that, half of 6 is 3, square that, we get 9. So add the 9 to both sides. I call the 9 the magic number, because the 9 in this case will make this factorable. If you factor this, you get x plus 3 times x plus 3, which is just x plus 3 squared, and that's equal to 13. And we can just take the square roots to both sides, to put a plus or minus. X plus 3 is equal to this, subtract 3 to both sides, we get x is equal to negative 3, plus or minus square root of 13, and then we are done. Now, the second case is when u is equal to negative 2. The u right here, I should have colored the u in red. The u is that, so x squared plus 6x, this time is equal to negative 2. We are going to add 9 because it's the same thing. So add 9, add 9. Right here, again, that will be x plus 3 squared. This time we get 7. Still, take the square roots to both sides, plus or minus, cancel this, subtract 3 to both sides. Ladies and gentlemen, x is equal to negative 3, plus or minus square root of 7. So, how many answers do we have? In fact, 4. The first one is negative 3 plus square root of 3. The second one is with the minus here. And then the third one is with the plus here. And then the fourth one is here. Now, why do we have 4 solutions? Well, because originally, when we have x squared times x squared, this is actually a fourth degree polynomial equation. And we end up with 4 different answers, which is pretty cool. And in fact, they are all real, which is very nice. That's it.